Hello and welcome to Jim and Tay Have Their Say.
What up, y'all and stuff?
Yeah. So,
sorry, I came over all hip for a second.
Yeah, he's very hip. Whew. Way hipper than me.
That's why I got an Arkansas t-shirt on. Super hip.
Well, Dad, you know, we just had the Oscars.
Yes.
We did.
We did.
We had the Oscars.
Oh, it was so much fun.
I didn't actually even watch the Oscars. I don't have television. But, I tuned in on socials to check out what happened. But I had a random question, I guess, which was like, when you first started acting, maybe this is like a depressing question, I don't know, but when you first started acting, did you have as one of your goals to win an Oscar?
I've had that goal from time to time, but I usually abandon it because yeah. I've early on became very kind of disenchanted with the Oscars. Okay. I know the exact moment. I was about 13. I used to watch the Oscars with some excitement on our black and white TV. And then the year, and this must be like 1972 maybe, the year that the first Poseidon Adventure movie came out.
Good movie.
Which was my favorite movie with Gene Hackman. Mm. And I was so disappointed that it didn't just sweep the Oscars. Everybody was great in it. It was probably the only grown-up movie I even saw that year.
Yeah.
You know, everything else was probably just, you know, corny stuff. And so I was like, I was a big advocate of the Poseidon Adventure. And when it did not win, I suddenly withdrew from the Oscars.
Mm.
It was like,
betrayal.
There's something wrong with this organization. Yeah. I don't know what it is, but I'm going to get to the bottom of it.
Yeah.
So, but then, of course, I grew up and I became a professional actor. And then, you know, as an actor, you're like, well, you should shoot for a big goal. You should be like the best actor. You should be in the running. And when I see people now, like Paul Giamatti, who was a contemporary of mine, and some of these other guys who are like, you're about my age, you know, but obviously their careers are in a completely different condition than mine. I think, well, wouldn't it be wonderful to be part of that club a little closer? I'm like the Neptune and they're like Mercury in terms of like the width of the concentric circles mm. around the Oscar. So yeah, so I unfortunately, and now when I watch the whole thing, almost all of it, I think, this year, which I don't like to do because it usually is a little bit depressing for me, because it's depressing in a lot of different ways, but mostly I just, the judging of the arts in that way is so kind of icky after a while. And I was talking to my friends that we sat and watched it with, and I shared this observation I have, is that as the evening goes on, when the shrine, it's not the shrine anymore, but the theater, the Dolby, is full of excited people with tremendous potential of winning.
Right.
And their friends might win, and their wives might win, and their husbands might win, and there's all these people that might win, and they're all just kind of bubbly and effervescent about it. And slowly, as the evening goes on, there's more and more disappointed people who have lost. Mm. Until the end, there's only everybody, all the winners have gone in through some portal to some magical place, and the room is full of people who are being good sports about the whole thing. So, you know, I'm sensitive to that, I guess. But it must be super fun.
Yeah, I understand all that. That makes total sense. I just thought of that randomly as like, oh, wow, this winning an Oscar must be, it's a goal of probably so many actors when they're starting their career.
Mm-hmm.
Because it is this idea of reach for the stars. It's so prestigious. But I've kind of come to feel the same way about it, where I'm like, wait a second. Like, this is somebody's judgment on what is the best. And then it's also a campaign.
Mm.
It's you're campaigning for this. So how much money are you going to put into this? How much promotion are you going to put into this? And those are the people that will win. It doesn't mean they're not good, but you also have to do those other things. It's not just you're the best actor or you're the best, this is the best film. So I understand. It's good to have big goals and to be part of our acting group, I think.
Mm.
But I think that there is more than the Oscars, maybe, is what I'm realizing.
And I think, you know, I totally agree with what you're saying. And I think that the actors that are up for Oscars are usually people that don't necessarily, their goal is probably not to get an Oscar. Their goal is to do a magnificent job and a really compelling and important piece of work
right.
that will be seen the world over and appreciated. And the Oscar is just sort of a byproduct of that.
Mm.
Anybody who's just going for the Oscar is going to wind up doing all kinds of ridiculous stuff.
Totally.
So, you know, like Bradley Cooper, who was dissed and totally robbed, I think, this year. Because, come on, Maestro, pretty good movie. Pretty aesthetic, wonderful movie. He wanted to tell a story. He worked harder than anybody would ever ask an actor to work to pull off that effect. He assembled a great team. You know, he did a lot of things right, and he took a huge amount of responsibility. It wasn't to win an Oscar, I don't think. I think it was to tell this story and to experience this man's life and to be that guy and all those other little things. And what does it feel like to conduct an orchestra for 6 minutes and then direct the movie and be responsible like that? And I don't know. I mean, I think that's the bigger goal. That's more exciting, so... So that's what I'm going for, and that's why my biopic about John Philip Sousa is going to be so... And why I'm taking tuba lessons now and learning how to march, I'm probably going to work on it for the next 12 years. Because he really didn't, I don't think, get famous until after his death. So...
So you'll be long gone
I'll be by long the time gone you win that Oscar. By the time, yeah. A posthumous Oscar. Nothing wrong with that. They're still good. They're still gold.
That's right. Well, what do you think about the Oscars and about our little discussion today? Let us know in the comments below. And, you know, we'd give you an Oscar for being so great.
Yeah, you get an honorary Oscar.